Okay, first and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Wahad Lakar Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and His Son's name is Yahweh Shai. And honors to the elder apostles of great Mosul that taught me this truth, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved in these last days. The wicked are like the troubled sea. Okay? The wicked are like the troubled sea. Start in Isaiah 57 and 19. Okay? This is Isaiah 57 and 19. And it says, I create the fruit of the lips, which is what the speech. Okay? Peace, peace to him that is far off and to him that is near. Okay? So bear me just a minute. When it says peace to him that is afar off and to him that is near, who would that be to? It'd be to what? Israelites that are far and that are near. And to him that is near, saith the Lord, I will heal him. So, yes, our nation is eventually going to be healed. And the elect, the hopeful, they're being healed on this side. And those of our people that are not healed now, they're going to be healed in the kingdom. But the wicked are like the troubled sea. Okay? Don't do that word wicked. Guilty of sin. Criminals. Okay? Ungodly. Okay? Are like the troubled sea. Right? Double-minded. Okay? Tripping. Okay? When you see the troubled sea, what is it? It's going to and fro, it's beating upon the shore. Okay, that's how the wicked are. That's how the wicked are. Okay, when it cannot rest, and a lot of the wicked, when we bring up these words, it causes people to not rest. The elites, we know that they can't rest. They're shaking, they're trembling. Okay, the woman's probably walking out on them. Okay, these waters cast up man and dirt. So that's what the wicked cast up, myrrh and dirt. Okay? Which is what? Deceit. Okay? Lies. Okay? This is what the wicked are likened unto. Alright? What else have we got? There is no peace, save my power, to the wicked. So yeah, of course there's no peace to the wicked. Okay? We're not going to have peace. And that's why Ezra, he wants to stop this word. Okay, because this is upsetting him. But good, that means you're being effective. If this word is affecting him, that means you're being effective. Right? If he's trying to stop you, that means you're being effective. Let's go to Psalms 10 and 4. Here we go, Psalms 10 and 4. The wicked for his pride of his countenance. Because if you want to see an example of pride, what's the example of pride? Esau. Okay. The wicked through his pride of his countenance will not seek after the Most High. But you can't expect Esau to seek after the Most High. Why? Because he's the devil. Okay, the devil the Bible speaks of. So of course he's not going to seek after the Most High. The Most High is not in all their thoughts. Right? He will not seek, that's his bit, will not seek after the Most High, for the Most High is not in all his thoughts. I didn't even realize that was there. Okay, the Most High is not in all his thoughts. He ain't thinking about the Most High. You really think he cares? That's why he wants control. That's why he's trying to what, put a chip, okay, in a majority of what people say. Okay? And when you read this in the American Standard Version, it is the evildoer in his pride says, the Most High will not make a search in all his thoughts. So this is the mindset of Esau, pride. Okay? But that pride's going to be taken down very, very soon. Okay? His ways are always grievous. Thy judgments are far above out of his sight. As for his enemies, he puffeth at them and taunts them. he hath said in his heart, I shall not be moved. That's that pride, the pride of Esau, for I shall never be in adversity. But if you read the scriptures let you know this man's going to be in straits. It tells you that in Job, his mouth is full of cursing, deceit, and fraud. And this is what the society brought up on. Cursing, deceit, fraud, under his tongue is mischief and vanity. Never trust this man. Never trust your enemy. He sitteth in the lurking places of the villages. Okay? Different towns, different cities, and in the secret place does he murder. Okay? Murder the innocent. And that's why he's got his troops out there in different parts of the earth. What? Murdering the innocent for his own ill-gotten gains. His eyes are privily set against the poor. And the poor, he's actually the poor, is Israel. His eyes are set amongst them like prey. He lieth in wait secretly as a lion. Bear me just a minute. You know what comes to mind? I didn't even think I would go into this, but this is how the spirit is. Quickly want to get Peter on deck. Know thine enemy. Esau, and you can also acquaint these scriptures to the wicked of our own people, because the wicked of our own people are just like Esau. Okay, so where would he bear with his neurons in Psalms 10 and 9? He lieth in wait secretly as a lion in his den. So what does a lion do? It crouches down and waits for its prey. He lieth in wait to catch the poor. And he does this through different legislation, through witchcraft, okay, through deception. He doth catch the poor when he draweth him into his net. He croucheth and humbleth himself. And that's why the scriptures never trust thy enemy. For like his rust is, so is his wickedness. Okay? And he humbleth himself that the poor may fall by his strong ones. He hath said in his heart, the most I have forgotten. He hideth his face, he will never see it. This is what Esau thinks. After 400 years, 500 years, pure wickedness that Yahweh said doesn't see. Now he sees everything. But he's just building up that tab. Okay? He hath said in his heart, the most I have forgotten. He hideth his face, he will never see it. Arise, O Lord, Jehovah Shah, O power, lift up thine hand, forget not the humble. Wherefore doth the wicked contend the Most High? Because that's what it seems like. Why do wicked just, in this kingdom, why is it that, look, we're serving the Lord to the best of our ability, we're still catching hell, we still get jacked up, and it's like the wicked, they're eating pork, they're deceiving people, they're doing all types of shenanigans, it's like nothing's happening, because Jehovah Shah is building up their tab. Okay, that's why. So don't ever think, well, why am I suffering? That's why you always got to read Job as well. Okay, wherefore doth the wicked contemn the Most High, and he hath said in his heart, thou wilt not require it. Thou hast seen it, for thou beholdest mischief and spite to require it with thy hand. The poor committeth himself unto thee, thou art the helper of the fatherless. Break the arm of the wicked and the evil man. Seek out the wickedness till thou find none. And that's what the house is coming to do. I want to go back to that bit where he crouches and humbles himself, but the poor may fall by his strong ones. Okay? And this is Esau when he pushes out these different legislations, these different rules, and so forth. But I quickly want to go to 2 Peter. Okay? Because Esau is also known as a lion. Okay? So let's go to 2 Peter 1, and we're going to jump straight to 8. Be sober. That's why you've got to be sober, spiritually sober, looking what's going on, right? You've got many enemies in this truth, Esau, even our own people, because your adversary, and the adversary goes into it, enemies of Yahweh Shem, Satan, the devil, and the devil means what? A counter-mate, the one who acts on part to side with the devil himself, which is Esau. So you've even got our own people that will act on working on behalf of the devil as a roaring lion. So it says our adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion. It's not an actual lion that's just chasing after you, but it's a similitude. This is what Dark's saying, as a roaring lion. So what does a roaring lion do? It seeks out its prey, and it gets the easiest prey. Wherever there's a wound, it may see a wound within that prey, it goes for it. It's not really gonna go for the strongest of prey, is it? Walketh about. So it says walketh. So this is speaking about what the spiritual demon Satan, and also what the counterpart, which is Esau. Okay? And I've got to say this as well, because I've noticed since I've been coming to camp, there's Adric Provocateurs walking past now. So this thing is really, really, really affecting the elites, really affecting these Edomites, and even the wicked of our own people that have walked, joined hand in hand with him, seeking whom he may devour. And when I look up that word devour, it says to destroy completely. So the spiritual demon Satan, along with Esau, his counterpart, is seeking to destroy the elect, to completely destroy them. Right? Verse 9, who resists steadfast in the faith, that's where you've got to resist the scriptures. Resist the devil and he shall flee. Apply the scriptures, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren. Okay, that are in the world. So there's other brethren that are of the elect that are going through the same thing that you're going through. Okay? So with this, David just said, you know what, there's more. David said, I haven't even started yet. Bear with just a minute. Let's go to Proverbs 11 and 18. Who are you fooling? You're only fooling yourself. Okay. Let's go to Proverbs. Okay, just know if you're doing this work sincerely, the best of your ability, everything Esau's doing is going to come to no avail, and it's only going to work against him. Okay? Let's go to Proverbs 11 and 18. The wicked worketh a deceitful work. Okay? So that would speak of what? The elite. They're working a deceitful work. Okay? A work that's not going to really profit them in the long run. Maybe in the short term, because Esau does things. Some may say, well, he's long-term. He's not. Well, you can't see. This is a short-term thing. Nobody can do wickedness for the rest of, for the whole of their life and just think they're going to sail off into the sunset. And this is what Esau thinks, because Esau, he's done all this wickedness, and you think, well, ain't nothing happened to him. So let's quickly go to Proverbs 11 and 18. Just a minute. Let's quickly run in. Get the definitions out. Bear me just a minute. Bear me just a minute after. 11 and 18. Okay, here we go. So when it says the wicked worketh a deceitful work, and remember what the scripture says in Job 9 and 24, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, he covers the face of the dead. So if the earth is, not if, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, so what's he going to be doing? Working wickedness. Okay, to work, to produce, to make, to put in order, to attend to. So that's what Esau is doing, attending to. A deceitful work. So what's Esau's deceitful work? So when you go into the word deceitful, shakah. Okay, which when you go into adversary, it's the same definition as well, shakah. Lie, deception, disappointment, falsehood. So this is the thing, Esau, he works of falsehood. Falsehood is his strength, which a man that has understanding, you know, falsehood, it has an end. But this is Esau's stronghold, it's falsehood, it's deception. What deceives or disappoints or betrays one, deceit, fraud, wrong, fraudulent, wrongfully, injurious, in testimony. So Esau, his whole trait is to be what? A deceiver. And it also ties into false or self-deceived prophets, a false tongue. So this is how this society is operated on what? Falsity. A deceitful work, which is what? A practice. Okay. Work. Okay. But to him that soweth, righteousness shall be a sure reward. So that's the main thing, to be sowing righteousness. And as long as you're sowing righteousness, okay, what's that going to do? It's going to conquer what? That wickedness. Because what? Mercy rejoices over judgment. Right? Righteousness, righteous act, justification, a sure reward. So the elect, they're going to have a sure reward. Okay? So some of that has the righteousness and the true life. And that's how you have life, through what? Righteousness. And the righteousness is through you have a shine, having that faith. Not so much through the law. So he that pursueth evil, pursueth it to his own death. So men that are pursuing evil, that are pursuing this world, they're pursuing it to their own death. Okay? And they that are of a froward heart, corrupt mind, perverse mind, are an abomination to the Lord, but such as are upright in their way are his delight. So hand join in hand. You want to join Esau, you want to join his society, you want to join with his idols, you want to uphold him, the wicked shall not be unpunished. So the wicked are still going to be unpunished, even though you want to join him, but the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. right? And the righteous are righteous through Yahweh Yahushua. Why? Because they don't have their sins imputed unto them. So with this lesson, I hope this is edifying. And until the next time, Shalom.